All right.
Last year?
Yes.
How are you feeling?
Bittersweet. I mean, this. If we just did a panel, it was kind of emotional, and you feel it as you're doing this, but then you get the panel and there's 3,000 people in the room, and you know, just this energy of it. So it's bittersweet. Yeah.
And you're in a very unique position because Steven is around, but you're technically in the current timeline the last OTA member standing. And where does that leave you? Where does that leave you in terms of the team, in terms of your personal life? Because we also haven't yet seen your second son come into the picture. So how does that your life change going forward?
Well, some of that we'll see. Obviously you don't have an Oliver Queen without Diggle someplace near his side, so that's part of our season. But also, just kind of, we'll wrap up those questions. There's a lot of questions that are answered in 10 episodes, which presents a bit of a challenge to the writers. It also makes each episode kind of its own little movie, because we're getting to the point very, very quickly. And for Diggle's story, it's what happens between he and Lila, who's the lead of Argus, what happens between he and his children, who grow up to be influential in the future. Is he or is he not Green Lantern? Those are kind of the big questions.
On that subject, because there's been all these teases, and this past season, your stepdad is literally named Stewart, so you're John Stewart Diggle.
Yeah.
I mean, what are the chances that the color green is part of Diggle's future in the final season?
You know something, it's...
In the ring.
I don't know if I had to put a percentage on it, I don't know. But it better be a big payoff, guys. This is the sixth season that I'm talking about. Have you seen the new wardrobe, new costume just came out? It's like another nod, right? It's like, of all the colors. This guy's now, he has a green helmet and green piping in his suit. So yeah, these things will be answered. And I think you guys will be happy with it.
But yes, okay, I will take that as a yes then.
I mean, you'll be happy.
What did you think about when you heard about kind of the new timeline and the flash forwards, and how do you like that for the character that you find out? And well, some things are preordained sort of in the comic books and stuff, but the idea that Diggle's got these two sons that are now, you know, maybe not what you might want Diggle's sons to be, at least one of them.
Yeah. What do I think about that in terms of just how, where the story goes with that?
Yeah.
I think that's great. I mean, it just somebody as, you'll see that, you know, if anyone should have a home that is somewhat in order and everyone's kind of in line, you would think it would be Diggle. And you find out this season that none of that happens for Diggle in the future, right? So, and I think that's great. That's the curveball. You want, that's far more interesting, I think, than his arc. But we answer the question as to why and where they are. I don't want to give up too much away about these brothers. But they're pivotal, and you find out what Diggle had to do with it.
Suffice it to say, he passed on some of his daddy issues or stepdaddy issues.
Yeah, and we'll be ironing some of that out too, right? Like you said, he's ultimately a steward. He didn't take the name. Maybe it does, or maybe it doesn't change the season.
When you went into this final season, did you have like a bucket list of things you wanted to do that you've asked the writers, besides a certain ring? Are there things that has been on your bucket list that you will get to see without giving any spoilers?
What goes on with he and Lila is really important to me. You know, just Diggle has always kind of been, I think probably one of the more centered characters. He has a family, he has a child. He's about probably, I've always seen him as like 3 to 5 years ahead of Oliver, just in terms of his development as a vigilante and as someone who balances this family life and vigilanteism, right? And he's done it well. So I think we have to answer that question. She's the leader of Argus, which, you know, I wouldn't call them nefarious, but they're, you know what kind of corporation they are. So I think we have to answer that. What happens with that relationship?
All right. Is there a character you would like to see most return for the final season?
Will there be one?
Is there a character that you would like to see most return for the final season?
I've always been partial to Mono Bennett and Deathstroke. This is me personally. You know what I mean? I've always just loved that character and loved his portrayal of it. I just can't imagine anyone doing it better. He just season two, I think, was our best season. And it's in no small part because of that. He was a great one.
Well, I know there's not much you can say about
there's
the crisis. I know there's not much you can say about the crisis, but it's one of the most iconic stories of all DC Comics. What is it like for you, after 8 years of being part of this, get to be part of that as Arrow goes out?
It's just one more thing that is like, wow. I mean, nobody could have called this, right? I mean, and it's just lightning in a bottle over and over and over and over and over. So you just kind of realize that, and you become real grateful for it, and just go, okay, thanks.
So you're excited, basically.
Very much so, and grateful.
Thank you.
Thank you.